I want to send a message of encouragement to all those who've been affected by the recent storms and tornadoes that have devastated many parts of the country. My heart's broken as I've watched the footage on the news. I've seen people searching for loved ones, families standing in what used to be their homes, just wondering how they're going to put the pieces of their lives back together. And as I've watched the news, it served as a humbling reminder, even to me, that there are those moments in our lives that bring us to our knees. They remind us that no matter how much we'd like to think we're in control, we simply are not the ones in control of our lives. Which begs the question, who is? Well, I believe that there is one who's in control of all things, even when our worlds feel like they're spinning out of control. God is with us. And so I hope you can be comforted and encouraged in knowing that as you face the impossible mountain of trying to put your lives and your families and your communities back together, there is one who will be with you every step of the way. Philippians 4:13 is a verse from the Bible that has brought me great strength during my own adversity. It says, I can do all things, not on our own strength, but through Christ who gives me strength. You and I, we're not strong enough, but it's okay. We don't have to be. God promises to be strong enough for us.
We could hear all the debris, the breaking, the roar, all of the mess that was going on outside. And when we came out, it was just another experience.
You must think I'm strong to give me what I'm going through. Well, forgive me if I'm wrong. But this looks like more than I can do on my own.
Back home right now. I can't even go back home.
Well, maybe that's the point. To reach the point of giving up. Cause when I'm finally at rock bottom, well, that's when I start looking up.
There's no words that can describe how I feel about it. It is just amazing that somebody does this for somebody else.
Strong enough, hands of mercy won't.
In the days and weeks ahead, the news headlines may change. We may hear less and less about the families and towns and cities that have been struck by these tornadoes, but the need is still great. I want to encourage you to visit SamaritansPurse.org to find out how you can get involved, how you can help, and how you can make a difference.